In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. How many of you actually followed along with that? Does it make sense? I heard a sure. Kind of. Maybe. Maybe not. The interesting part of this reading is it's actually the Revised Common Lectionary's reading for Christmas morning. This is the reading that's supposed to happen on December 25th if we were to have a Christmas morning service. But it's the passage that those who did the narrative lectionary picked for the fourth Sunday of Advent. Because it pulls us and drives us and gives us hope. You might be thinking, Where's the hope? Right? The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. This is not... And then there was that part in there, where was that, when Paris read it? The part about John. John testified to him, he cried out, "This is he of whom I said, 'He who comes after me ranks ahead of me because he was before me.'" So he who comes after me ranks ahead of me, because he didn't actually come after me, he came before me. Because in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And who is the Word? Yeah, louder.
Jesus.
Jesus is the Word. The word in Greek is logos. It's also logic, but the word logos is, in the beginning was the logos, and the logos was with God, and the logos was God, and logos means Jesus, right? So Jesus was there in the beginning, and helped create everything, and at one time he came to dwell among us. And what does it mean to dwell, right? It said, the reading was a little off this morning. What did the reading say? Anybody remember? The Word became flesh and lived among us. What does it mean to live among people?
Be with.
To be with? Okay, but I can live amongst my neighbors and I don't really necessarily have to be with them. Right? How many of you know your neighbors? By name? First name, not last name. I say, how many of you actually spend time with your neighbors? You're concerned about your neighbors. I would actually say that's more than living with your neighbors. Because you can live in a community and not actually know the people you live with. And that's not what this word here means, right? Jesus, the Word, became flesh. Kind of like a few weeks ago, we had the dry bones and they came alive, right? And they were flesh. And then Jesus did what? Or God did what? Do you remember? He did what?
He breathed.
He breathed into them. And when he breathed into them, he breathed into life. Just like in the beginning, right? God created man and gave them life. Jesus, the Word, became flesh and, like I said, here it says, lived among us. I better find it again. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. In the way that I remember this verse is, the Word became flesh and he dwelt among us. Okay? You might say, well, Pastor, are we splitting hairs? And I would say, I don't have any to split, so let's not split them. What's the difference between to live with or among, or to dwell with and among? What's the difference? What does dwell mean? This is super important to understand this text.
Stay for a while.
To stay for a while. Right? You kind of like, isn't that taking up residence? Live in a neighborhood. So is that the same?
Live kind of seems that like a beginning and an end.
So So living has a set time period, but dwelling could be an open-ended.
Well, it also could be the middle of living. You know, you're living, you're born, and you die. You live.
The dash, right? The dash is important. To dwell. I would say, with what we're hitting on, there's not really a lot of difference between living and dwelling, and you're probably at this point wondering, when are you actually going to get to the point here? Right? I've got lunches to get to, I've got prison stuff to open.
Can you speed this up a little bit?
The word dwell is the most important word in this text. Out of all of these 14, 15, how many verses there are, right? The word became flesh, and he came to live or to dwell among us. And this word for dwell actually means, before we get to that, one question. See exactly, you see this face? How many of you have ever gone camping? Like, RV or tent camping? Let's see, how many of you have ever gone tent camping? Is that like living in a house?
No, it's not, is it? You have to really like the people you're going to go tent camping with, to go camping with them, right? You have to want to be in a relationship and understand who they are and get along with their quirks, or at least know their quirks enough that you can get over them, right?
This word here for dwell is actually the word for tenting. The word became flesh and tented among us. See, the thing that's important about this is that God didn't come to just stay or to be with you. God came to live with you and to be intimate with you. God left his throne on high and was not aloof to the problems that we have. He was not passive to the problems that face us. He didn't show non-concern for the people that he created, but he had so much concern that he said, I'm going to go and not only become one of them, but I'm going to go and be intimately involved with them. And I'm going to become the light, right? And that's why the last verses are important. What does the very last verse say? So this is actually the only verse in all of this section of John that all the translations actually have exactly the same. The first part of verse... Is it 18 is the last one?
Yes.
The first part of verse 18, what does it say?
No one has ever seen God.
It's the only verse that all the translations have exactly the same. And we have never seen God. But what does God do for us? Because Jesus came and dwelt among us. And he was the life, and in him was the In him was the light of the world. We can't see the light. Right? I can't see the light. But the light allows me to see what God intended for all of us. It helps me to see the love that God has given to his creation. And it helps me to understand who it is that I'm supposed to be. By not allowing myself to get in the way, but allowing God's love to shine through my life. Messed up as it is, the light still comes through. So know on this last Sunday, as we await the coming of Jesus in this manger. See, he's not here yet. We have Mary and Joseph and some animals, and we're waiting. Know that Jesus comes to dwell with you. Jesus comes to tent with you. Jesus comes to live in an intimate relationship with you. He wants you to become transparent so that his light can illuminate the world and show them the love that God has given to all of us in this baby that comes in the future. So let your light so shine, so that everyone can see the good works that God does through you and know how much he loves them to come and to live, to tent with us.